Jaya Radha Madhava Punya Vihari
Jaya Radha Madhava Punya Vihari
Jaya Radha Madhava Punya Vihari
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasa.
Tato Jaya Mudiraye
Nashta Prayeshu Abhadreshu
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki
Vasudeva Sutam Devam
Kamsa Chanura Marthanam
Devaki Paramanandam
Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum.
So we'll read the verse. Tatascha Shaurir Bhagavat Prachoditaha.
Sutam Samadaya
Sasutikagraha.
Yada Bahir Gantum Aeshat Tardhihaja.
Ya yoga maya jani nanda jayaya
tataksha shaurir bhagavat prachoditaha
sutam samadhaya sasutika graha
Yada bahir gantum aesha
tarhiyajam.
Ya yoga maya jani nanda jayaya.
Jaya
tatascha shaurir bhagavat prachoditaha.
Sutam samadaya sasutika graha
Yada bahir gantum aesha
tarhiyaja
Ya yoga maya jani nanda jayaya
Anybody else want to?
Sutam samadaya sasutika graha
sutam samadaya sasutika
disease. Anybody wants to? Tataha, thereafter, cha, indeed, shaurihi, vasudev, bhagavat prachoditaha, being instructed by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, sutam, his son, samadhaya, carrying very carefully, sa, he, sutika, Sutika Grahat from the maternity room. Yada, when Bahi Gantum to go outside. Ayesha, desired. Tarhi, exactly at that time. Aja, the transcendental energy. Who also never takes birth. Ya, who? Yogamaya is known as Yogamaya. Ajani took birth. Nanda Jayaya from the wife of Nanda Maharaj. Translation and purport by Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki. Thereafter, exactly when Vasudev, being inspired by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, was about to take the newborn child from the delivery room, Yogamaya, the Lord's spiritual energy, took birth as daughter of wife of Nanda Maharaj. Purport. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur discusses that Krishna appeared simultaneously as the son of Devaki and as the son of Yashoda, along with the spiritual energy Yogamaya. As the son of Devaki, he first appeared as Vishnu. And because Vasudev was not in a position of a pure affection for Krishna, Vasudeva was worshipped his son as Lord Vishnu. Yashoda, however, pleased her son Krishna without understanding his godhood. This is the difference between Krishna as the son of Yashoda and as a son of Devaki. This is explained by Vishwanatha Chakrabarti on the authority of Hari Vamsha.
Om Adhyanati Mirandasya Dhyananjana Shalakaya Chakshushun Malitam Mena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Maro Vishtam Stapitam Mena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadanti Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Gurum Shri Juta Padakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamsha, Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam, Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam, Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakan Vitamsha, He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate, Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute, Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabho Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Kannada dalli anuvada FM radio 93. Okay. This is a very nice shloka from 10th canto. Talks about the birth of Lord Krishna. Here, Sukadeva Goswami uses something called thereafter. Why did he say tatastha? Tatastha is thereafter. Why did he say thereafter? That is, basically,
Krishna has already taken birth. Okay. And Krishna, Lord, Supreme Personality of Godhead is already telling Mother Devaki and Vasudev that in their previous life what they were, okay, when they wanted to, Lord Brahma wanted to, on the instruction of Supreme Personality of Godhead to extend the progeny. So that time, they were in the first life, Prishni and Sutapa. They actually meditated 12,000 years on Supreme Personality of Godhead. And when Lord appeared, normally when we ask, when Lord appears, what we ask normally is liberation. They didn't ask for liberation. Immediately, Mother Devaki asked, I want to have a son like you. So, it is very difficult to have son like Lord Krishna, right? Very difficult. He can only come. Nobody else is like Lord Supreme Lord. He can only come as a Lord, son. Nobody is like Lord. So, he is born as Prishni Garbha to Prishni and Sutapa in that life. And in the next life, and they were actually appear as Aditi and Kashyapa. And from there, Vamandev, Lord Vamandev, his name is also Bhargav, I think, right? Bhargav is born. Huh? Upendra is born. And he is Lord Vamandev. And this is a third life they are getting. And when Kamsa is actually taking Mother Devaki to her place, there was a Akashavani, they call, no? So, that in the eighth garbha of Devaki is going to kill you. And that is how Devaki and Vasudeva were put on shackles in the jail. And there were a lot of doorkeepers. And all the six children were already been killed by Kamsa. And Lord is already taken his appearance through the womb of Mother Devaki and in the four-handed form. Imagine you are all waiting outside the labor room and imagine a child is being born with four hands, Shankha Chakra Gada Padma. And immediately what he will say, no, this is not a normal baby. Immediately, you know, in the olden, even now, normally, you know, old people, normally what they do, immediately they will check all the fingers are right, hands are right, whether some babies are born with six fingers and all these things they check. But imagine the child is born with Shankha Chakra Gada Padma in the hand. And also yellow dhoti and the kaustubha and everything. So that is Lord. Okay. So he is born as four hands and he is giving that confidence to Mother Devaki and Vasudev and they are praying. They are actually telling them, don't worry. If Kamsa sees you that he is going to says after you and that this and all, he is going to kill you also. I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead and Kamsa cannot do anything. I am born because of this purpose only ఇట్ సేస్ ఇన్ భగవద్గీత పవిత్రాణాయ సాధూనాం వినాశాయ చ దుష్కృతాం. సో ఐ హ్యావ్ కమ్ ఫర్ దాట్ ఓన్లీ. సో ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ దేవకీ ప్రేజ్, లార్డ్ ప్లీజ్ అపియర్ ఇన్ యువర్ టూ హ్యాండ్స్ ఫార్మ్ అండ్ సుప్రీం పర్సనాలిటీ ఆఫ్ గాడెడ్ టెల్స్ వసుదేవ్ దట్ ద టోటల్ ప్లాన్ ఆఫ్ టేకింగ్ హిమ్ అండ్ టు ఎక్స్చేంజ్ ద బేబీ విత్ మదర్ యశోద. సో ఆల్ ద హోల్ స్టోరీ, హోల్ ప్లాన్ ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ టు వసుదేవ్ అండ్ వసుదేవ్ ఈజ్ పికింగ్ ది బేబీ ఇన్ హిజ్ హ్యాండ్ అండ్ ద ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ గివన్ బై హోమ్ సుప్రీం పర్సనాలిటీ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ హెడ్ అండ్ హీస్ పికింగ్ ద బేబీ అండ్ టెల్లింగ్ దేవకి సీ దిస్ బేబీ లుక్స్ లైక్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ లైక్ మీ ఓన్లీ సంథింగ్ లైక్ దాట్ యు నో. సో 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 మచ్ అఫెక్షనేట్లీ అండ్ దెన్ హీ పిక్స్ ద బేబీ అండ్ పుట్స్ ఇట్ ఇన్ అ స్మాల్ బాస్కెట్ లైక్ థింగ్ ఆన్ అ సాఫ్ట్ క్లాత్. ఇట్ టాక్స్ అబౌట్ ఇట్ హియర్ అండ్ ఇన్ పర్టిక్యులర్ దిస్ వర్స్ ఇట్ టాక్స్ అబౌట్ షౌరి. హూ ఇస్ షౌరి హియర్? Shauri is Vasudev. Tatascha Shauri. Why is he called Shauri? Shauri means he is a son of Shursen. And also he was a very powerful king. He is also a very powerful king. And when Kamsa is taking Devaki to leave her to her place, when Akashavani actually came through and he was about to go and kill Devaki, that time who pacifies? Without taking any weapon in the hand, he wins the battle with Kamsa. So that's why he is also called Shauri. There are 2-3 reasons that he is called Shauri. And he is also Shauri now because he is completely shackled in the jail and Krishna is giving the plan. And he is worried, who is going to take out my shackles? And there are 16 doors that he has to pass. 16 doors that he has to pass. And that does not relate to your chanting 16 rounds. I will tell you later why. Why those 16 doors and what it represents. And he has to pass these 16 doors. And there are doorkeepers. So he's also going through this. He's a Shauri. So there are 3 reasons why he's called Shauri. So he's also son of Shursen. And without taking any weapon in his hand, he wins the battle with Kamsa. And the third thing is, he is now going to make an adventure in the night. In the midnight, he is taking the baby out of this jail, passing 16 doors, passing Yamuna and going to Nandagram and exchanging the baby and coming back. And fourth one, you know why he is called Shauri? Anybody can guess why he is called Shauri? The 6 babies are murdered in front of his eyes. The 6 babies are murdered in front of his eyes. When the babies are murdered, normally Devaki is put into sleep by Yogamaya. But the 6 babies are murdered. So he is called Shauri. So I will tell you why this, once the plan is ready, and So he is carrying now, his everything is ready. And he has to take these 16 doors. The 16 doors represent five of them are the knowledge senses, five of them are the working senses, and the 11th one is the mind, and the next five are Bhumi, Rapo, Nalo, Vayu, earth, water, air, fire, ether. So there are 16 doors that he has to pass. So, and with the yoga maya effect, all the gatekeepers are going to sleep, and the shackles that they are going to be put in, one leg they have put shackles and they can only go in a semicircle. The shackles wide open, they break open, means released. So what is the principal theory of these three things? The shackles are released, and the doorkeepers are put into sleep, and the doors, all the 16 doors are being opened. What is the principal effects of this? So when, can anybody guess what is the principal effect of this? Anybody who is taking Krishna on their head, the shackles of the birth, death, old age and disease are released. So, he is taking on head, also he has already taken in his heart. The people who take Krishna in their heart will immediately release from the shackles of birth and death. That is the first principal effect of this. The second principal effect, the gatekeepers are put into sleep. What does this represent? The six anarthas that we have, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya, in our own this thing, they are all put into sleep. Six anarthas. What is the principal effect of the gates opening? Or the gate of Goloka Vrindavan opens for you, if these three things are done. Even if you carry Krishna on your tongue, okay, all these six anarthas are put into sleep. So this is the message that we need to carry. So what is that Vasudeva is thinking now outside? Once he comes outside the gate, he is already carried. What is he thinking now in his mind? How do I cross Yamuna River? Is he not thinking that? How do I cross Yamuna River? And what is the second thought that he has when he comes out? Nobody should see him in Mathura. The two things, right? Yes or no? Nobody should see him. Number one. Number two is, he has to cross, how to cross a Yamuna River. The two things. So immediately what happens? Indra started pouring rain. So when Indra started pouring rain, there is again an analogy given to that. Analogy is given to this. What is the analogy given? As soon as he comes out, and when Lord is appeared, his color is compared to what? The clouds outside today, because he is born in Shravana, Krishna Paksha, on the Ashtami day. Correct? So it is a rainy season. And rainy seasons, the clouds are rainy clouds, like Megha Sham. And Krishna is actually, Krishna's complexion is a Megha Sham complexion. right? So immediately clouds became very happy. Krishna is compared to our complexion, right? Our complexion. So they are happy with the happiness, the tears are coming out. So showers are coming. The first thing. Second, you know, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam. Right? So the clouds are telling we don't have patram, we don't have pushpam, we don't have phalam. We are giving only toyam to Krishna. So they are giving pure water to Krishna. The third thing, they are thinking, anyway, Krishna is bathed between the two mothers, the breast milk. Okay. In between that, he has appeared today. Let me shower him. Let me give abhishek, do abhishek with the pure water of rain. In between that, he's already taken from the, he was from Devaki's, Mother Devaki's to Mother Yashoda. So in between that, at least I can shower, I can do abhishek. And the fourth thing, the acharyas actually give analogies. This ocean, this is a little bit of a scientific analogy is given. Little bit of a scientific. The ocean is a Kshirasagar, right? And the daughter of Kshirasagar is Lakshmi, Lakshmi Devi. And Lakshmi Devi is the internal consort of Vishnu. Vishnu is none other than Krishna. So, and to Krishna, what the Kshirasagar becomes? Sasur, correct? Father-in-law of Krishna, correct? Yes or no? Sasur. So we have to be, somebody was telling, you know, three people we have to be very careful with. One is Sur, second is Asur, and the third is Sasur. So, he actually sending, he's ordering, he's sending the clouds to rain. See, you know, you operate and becomes a cloud and rain. Before in hand, you know, I want to wash the feet of my son-in-law. That is another analogy is given. And the fifth analogy is given by acharyas is, water is also called jivan. Right? Yamuna jivan. What is that? Keli Parayan, is it? What is that next, this thing? Yamuna Jeevana Keli Parayana. So, Jeevan is also called life. And Krishna is life of all the life, correct? Ultimate life. That is why is pouring. You got my point? How is the whole analogy is given? Then next, so when Krishna is carrying, although it was a very difficult situation. And the last thing, we know what happens when it rains, normally what happens? When it rains, the people from outside will go inside. And what happens to people inside will never come outside. Correct? It is raining. And the third thing is, the people from inside, they become lazy and go to sleep when it is pouring, right? Yes or no? See the analogies. And the fourth one, what happens fourth one? Even if you are outside, it is when it is heavily raining, you can't see each other. Yes or no? It is heavily raining, normally you put in, you know, in cars and all, you put wipers, right? You can't see each other. And because of the sound of rain, it is raining outside and the sound, rain makes a lot of sound, you know. And Vasudeva's steps are not heard by anybody. He is going because Vasudeva's feet were very big and, you know, his steps are not heard. So, there are the five analogies are given. See, he is thinking nobody should see. So, Sri Jagannath Baldev Subhadramai ki jai, Gaurnitai ki jai, Lakshmi Narasimhadev Bhagavan ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. You got my point, no? That two worries he had. One is crossing the Yamuna and nobody should see him. So for nobody should see him, Indra actually clouds, everybody helped. And what happens when it rains also is being discussed here. Correct? So now, who comes now to protect him? Adishesh comes. Adishesh comes from behind and giving a shelter to both Vasudev and Lord Krishna. Why did he not come from the front? Why Vasudev did not, Adishesh did not come from front? Because Vasudev may get afraid, you know, because Vasudev is not even knowing that Shesh is giving the shelter for him. And second thing, don't you think rains are actually giving their devotional service to Lord Krishna and Shesh is obstructing them? Adishesh is obstructing them? Yes or no? But actually he was doing like this, it seems. He was going and coming like this and they're going again. He was also making sure that some showers, small showers come there. And rest of it he was taking. So it is a very many things to learn from this. So he crosses the Yamuna River. And just at that time when Vasudev has picked the baby Krishna, Yogamaya is born there in Nandagram. So he goes to Nandagram and picks the baby up. And when he comes back, automatically all the doors are open and they are still sleeping and he comes and puts the shackles. So, can you not think he has carried Krishna to Nandagram, and on the way back he has carried Maya? Yes or no? She's Yoga Maya, right? So there is you need to think that devotees, even if they carry sometime Yoga Maya, okay, it's a little, sometimes, you know, we are in little miserable condition. Once in Juhu, this is a little bit of a Prabhupada pastime. And when Juhu temple was being built, and once Prabhupada was sitting like this, right, putting his hand on a head and he was sitting there. And this pastime is being normally explained by, you know, Giriraj Maharaj. And one devotee asked him, "Why Prabhupada, why are you sitting like this?" And Prabhupada says, "This project is a headache. this project is a headache. Then devotee says, then why are you doing it? You say it is a headache, then why are you doing it? I know it is headache, but it is blissful. So, Prabhupada pastime, you know, you work for Maya. When you work for Maya, Prabhupada says, when you work for Maya, you get headache. When you work for Krishna, you get bigger headache. And he further says, that headache when you work for Maya is miserable. And that bigger headache when you work for Krishna is blissful. So, you know, yesterday, half of the Janmashtami is celebrated. One day Janmashtami is celebrated, both the places. All of you are tired. So much of organizing when you do for Janmashtami, you know. Now, somebody is going to do Kirtan. Prabhu has organized Kirtan roster and class roster, and Abhishek has to happen, crowd control has to happen, publicity has to happen, and so many things. You know, Krishna Janmashtami celebration is not an easy. Any festival in the temple is not easy. So much organizing has to take place. And devotees get tired, but they are very blissful when they see in the morning. Very blissful. They enjoy their services. Even though they are tired, they enjoy their services. That is the difference between working for people and working for Lord. You know what I mean? So, the stories of these pastimes of Lord are very, 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 very blissful and very nice to hear. You know, somebody was telling me other day, he asked me a question. I was listening to a lecture. He said, what is the difference between Rama avatar and Krishna avatar? Actually, Krishna is not an avatar. He came in full. He came as a supreme, his full form. What is the difference between that? Can anybody say? What is the difference between Rama avatar and Krishna avatar? Okay, what else? He came for you, keep this thing in your mind. Pavitranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushkrutam. Keep that principle in your mind and differentiate. What is the difference between Krishna avatar and Rama avatar? And very interestingly, he said, Ram avatar, Ram went to demons and killed them in their place. And Krishna never went anywhere. All demons came to him and Krishna killed them. Putana came. And Trinavarta came. When they were playing, Bakasura came. When they were playing, Agasura came. All the demons came to him and Krishna killed them. And in Ram avatar, Ram went to all those demons and killed them. That is the main difference, they say, compared to this using this principle. And he was also further telling, in Mahabharata it comes, Jarasandha actually attacked on a Dwaraka 18 times, okay, with so many Akshohini, Sainya. He took them and attacked them. In that Sainya, there were a lot of demons. Every time the Jarasandha had attacked the Dwaraka, and Krishna killed all the demons, and he left only Jarasandha back again. And when Rajasuya Yajna was going on, and Yudhishthira was making Rajasuya Yajna, and there was only one king left, was Jarasandha, you know. He was supposed to be killed. And Lord asks, you give me Bhima and Arjuna, I will go and finish Jarasandha also and come. And that time, Yudhishthira actually questions. He's not supposed to question, but he questions. You were not able to kill Krishna when he came 18 times when he attacked you. How are you confident that you are now going to kill him? That time Krishna explains this. He said, I have left Jarasandha because he is collecting all the demons to come and attack me so that I can kill them at one spot. Now it is a time all the demons are finished. Now it is a time to kill Jarasandha. And there is a specific person in Mahabharata, you know, to kill different personalities. Okay. That is again a pastime attached to it. Okay. So Bhima was supposed to kill Jarasandha. That's why he took Bhima and Arjuna to kill Jarasandha. So very nice pastimes, you know. And when Rajasuya Yajna was going on, he had given a promise to his paternal mother, like this side, you know, who said, Shishupala's mother. So basically, he's a father's sister. So he had given, when you are listening to these things, you know, like the pastimes of Lord, you feel sometimes that you are present. Such a very attractive pastimes. When you listen to them, you feel that you are actually witnessing that yajna, and you're witnessing Krishna killing, you know, Shishupal. Shishupal keep on making, you know, offenses to Lord. So these things are very nice. So we are learning, recap the whole thing. What did we learn today? Which are those 16 doors? Represent 16 doors represent five knowledge senses, five working senses. 11th one is the mind. And five Bhumirapo Nalo Vayu. Then you also learned something. What is that you learned? Krishna is? Yes. The three things. The shackles are released and the gatekeepers went to sleep and the gates are open. So what is the principal theory of this understanding? When shackles are, when you carry Krishna in your heart, okay, the shackles of the birth, death are released, okay. Second one, when you carry even Krishna on your tongue, right, what happens? The anartha, the sixth anarthas are put to sleep. And the third thing, gate opening is the Goloka Vrindavana gate opens for you when you carry Krishna in your heart. Right? So these are the three learnings that we can take. And on this day, this thing should be remember Krishna and don't forget him. By how to carry Krishna in your heart? By chanting loudly, attentively. There are nine processes of bhakti. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasevanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Atma Nivedanam, all these things. At least two of the things, first two, Shravanam and Kirtanam. So these two things are very important. So chant your rounds. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. So thank you very much.